Hi, let's talk about the differences between bronchial and pulmonary arteries. In this video, we'll discuss pulmonary versus bronchial vasculature. To understand pulmonary versus bronchial vasculature, we need to understand the fundamental difference between the pulmonary and systemic circuits. You might call them circuits, circulations, or loops. They all mean the same thing. The pulmonary circuit is the series of vessels which serve the alveolar capillaries. The major function here is gas exchange in the alveoli. This circuit begins in the right ventricle of the heart. Blood leaves through the pulmonary valve, through the pulmonary trunk, out through pulmonary arteries, eventually to the alveolar capillary beds, where gas is exchanged and richly oxygenated blood returns to the left atrium of the heart via pulmonary veins. So in this circuit, pulmonary arteries carry deoxygenated blood, and pulmonary veins carry oxygenated blood. We can contrast that with systemic circulation, which begins in the left ventricle of the heart. Blood is pumped out through the aortic valve, through the main conduit, the aorta. That blood is returned back to the heart after supplying metabolically active tissues of the body with oxygen for chemiosmosis via the caval system. So there is an inferior vena cava and a superior vena cava that return that blood to the right atrium. Let's take a look at this in a little more detail. So the pulmonary loop begins in the right ventricle. Here we are, our right ventricle. 100% of cardiac output is leaving the right ventricle and heading out through the pulmonary trunk to the pulmonary arteries, which then serve capillary beds around the alveoli of the lungs. Blood is then returned through four major pulmonary veins to the left atrium. We can also see here an interesting vascular novelty. That's the ligamentum arteriosum, which is a remnant of the ductus arteriosus, which in fetal circulation is going to conduct relatively oxygenated blood from the pulmonary trunk in the vicinity of the origin of the left pulmonary artery out to the arch of the aorta. So this is a bypass of pulmonary circulation in utero. We can also see examples of pulmonary arteries and pulmonary veins. These pulmonary veins return that blood to the left atrium, which is deep here to the base of the heart. The key point is that these pulmonary arteries and veins are serving alveolar capillaries. This is 100% of cardiac output. Everything that's leaving the right ventricle is going through these capillaries. In terms of the pulmonary arteries, we can see them here and here. They have a very, very close association with the bronchi. Those pulmonary arteries and their branches are going to mirror the tracheobronchial tree. On the other side of the alveolar capillary beds, there are going to be tributaries that coalesce into pulmonary veins. These pulmonary veins are hypervariable. But ultimately, they're going to coalesce into a superior and an inferior pulmonary vein in each lung. This tributary system will be completely independent of the pulmonary artery branches. It will be completely independent of the tracheobronchial tree. In fact, we'll see tributaries into these veins, both from within and between different bronchopulmonary segments. So there is no fidelity here between the pulmonary veins and the bronchopulmonary segments or the conductive system that supplies them. We can contrast that with the bronchial arteries. Bronchial arteries are a part of the systemic circuit. That systemic circuit serves all of the metabolically active tissues in the body. Its main conduit is the aorta. The aorta has a descending aorta that follows the arch of the aorta that has two parts, a thoracic and an abdominal part. The thoracic part of that descending aorta is what we'll be focusing on throughout this block. There are both visceral branches and parietal branches. We've already discussed some of the parietal branches. So the posterior intercostal arteries, those posterior intercostal arteries leave the thoracic part to supply the intercostal spaces with blood. And from the thoracic part, we'll have posterior intercostal arteries 3 through 11. There are also various visceral branches, and we'll discuss most of these in the context of the posterior mediastinum, but now we'll discuss the bronchial arteries. These bronchial arteries are going to supply the bronchi, as per their name, as well as the lung connective tissue, or stroma, with blood. They never reach the alveolar capillary beds. These terminate near, but not at, the respiratory bronchioles. So they strictly supply the conductive portions of the respiratory pathway. They also are going to supply regions of the esophagus that are near, as well as the roots of the lung. So there's going to be bronchopulmonary lymph nodes, also known as hilar nodes, that they supply. These bronchial arteries are tiny. They're going to receive at maximum 2% of total cardiac output. Their blood, interestingly enough, is largely returned via the pulmonary veins of the pulmonary circuit. Some of that blood also is going to be returned via bronchial veins, and those bronchial veins drain into the azygos system. These bronchial arteries are quite variable. The typical pattern is that we will have two left bronchial arteries that arise directly from the thoracic part of the aorta in the vicinity of the third posterior intercostal arteries. There's also typically only one right bronchial artery. That right bronchial artery is most likely to originate from the right third posterior intercostal artery, but it may also arise from the left superior bronchial artery. It then would be most likely to arise from the left inferior bronchial artery, but it might also arise from another right posterior intercostal artery, or even be a branch of the thoracic aorta. So we've discussed the differences between pulmonary and systemic circulation and the pulmonary vasculature, which is of the pulmonary circuit, and the bronchial arteries, which are of systemic circulation. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.